Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Dito Octaviani. I'm here to explain a little about the right implementation of work from home and study from home in pandemic COVID-19. Since 1 month ago, the term work from home and learn from home seemed to be the main topic in all lines of communication. This is related to call of the President of the Republic of Indonesia, Joko Widodo, to conduct social distancing of the spread of the coronavirus, which by WHO has been designated a pandemic. Prior of Indonesia countries with highest rates of coronavirus spread had already implemented work from home and learning from home in the activity of their citizens. The governments, company, education institution, and the community have also begun to implement supporting methods and application that can make work from home and learn from home activities effective while maintaining work productively and learning. In addition to studying at home, most employers also do work from home. In addition, standard email and conversation application working from home, and also use applications such as Microsoft Teams to coordinate work and Zoom Cloud to conduct video conferencing. Surely there will be a number of different things that need to be adjusted and implemented. Job priorities and target also need be adjusted. But the policy also has positive and negative things. The positive things, we can work and study at home without having to get out the house, and we can be closer to the family. While the negative things experienced by some employees or studying have to download many applications that are located on mobile phone that are currently booming. Applications such as Zoom capable of being hacked by irresponsible hacker. As a result, many applications user will concept such as their data account were broken into hacking user bank's account. And other negative things were experienced by studying throughout Indonesia. Many students complain about the difficulties of studying at home and the wastable quota that they used to study at home. Many tertiary institutions provide subsidy to their students, and there are also tertiary institutions which at time have a response at all about credit subsidization, not to mention that students who live in remote area finds it very difficult to get a signal. As a result, they have to walk kilometer up the mountain and even climb to the tower just for to study. With this, it could be a good policy for the government to do when this pandemic condition is more enhanced security, given that we work and study at home is something that can help medical personnel there in preventing the spread of COVID-19. And one of the easy ways to prevent its spread is by doing activities inside the house. This is the time we work together, helping each other and asking people mutual cooperation. We want this to become a community movement so that the COVID-19 issue can be handled optimally. So a few of my explanatory speeches about the right implementation of work from home and study from home in pandemic COVID-19. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.